Hello, 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 friends. Welcome to our YouTube channel where we are basically presenting mathematics lessons. So, in this presentation, we continue dealing with social and commercial arithmetic. But I must be quick to mention that this is lesson number four. All right? So, in this lesson number four, we are trying to understand what an investment bond is. All right? For example, if it's in here in Zambia, we have heard people talking about the euro bond and the like. So what is really a bond? What is an investment bond? That is our interest that we want to, that is our interest for this presentation. We want to really understand the nitty-gritties of an investment bond. All right, now to start with, when we talk about an investment bond is basically a loan that is given to government, to maybe a company, a municipality, because such institutions normally require huge sums of money which an ordinary financial institution may not be able to pay. Alright? So we are saying an investment bond is a loan to a company or government that pays a fixed rate of return. Alright? It's a fixed rate of return that is paid. But what we are saying is that in simple terms, we're talking about investment bond, we are talking about a loan. Right? But in most cases, this loan is given to big institutions, big companies, or even governments, because they might require sums of money to undertake certain projects and certain activities, which an ordinary financial institution may not be able to finance. Alright? So it's a loan, basically. Alright? Now, we are saying we have some remarks here. What are we saying? What we are saying is, bonds are used by companies, for example, municipalities, states and government to finance projects and activities. If as a government you have realized that we need to use sums of money to finance maybe this project, for example, roads. Alright? So you might require to go for a bond. Alright? You might require or you might need to issue a bond. By issuing a bond, it's like the government is getting a loan. Alright? So if you're able to finance such projects, we are able to undertake such activities. So what are you saying here? Companies, states, and municipalities normally use these bonds. The amount purchased is called face value. Something very interesting here. We are saying the amount purchased is called a face value. If the government issues a bond of 100,000, that 100,000 is called a face value. Maybe in loose terms or simple terms, you might say it's a principal. But in this language, we are saying it is a face value. Alright? Then, when you issue that bond, you'll be required to pay a fixed interest. Alright? You'll be required to pay an interest on that bond. So that interest that you'll be paying to the people that have given you the money, called the bond holders, alright, is called the coupon rate. Alright? So we're saying the rate of interest of the face value at which the bond will be paid is referred to as is called the coupon rate. Now, what the coupon rate? We are saying this must be paid regularly. Alright? Yearly before the bond matures. So if your bond is going to mature in 10 years, meaning that every year you must pay an interest. Now, there are consequences of skipping or defaulting on the interest. What might happen is, depending on the conditions, the bondholders might recall their money. It means you might be required to pay the face value and even the interest at the same time. Alright? Or they might impose in other penalties. So it's not advisable to default. Alright? Good. So we are saying the interest that you're going to be paid is referred to as the coupon what? Rate. Coupon rates are very important. So always try governments to meet those coupon rates, otherwise there could be consequences. Alright? So if you're paying the coupon rates, yeah, then at the end of the bond, when the bond matures, you'll be given the face value, the amount that you purchased. Alright? I hope we have tried to make it clear. We are saying a bond is a loan. Alright? TZ, a loan, but it's structured in such a way that you keep on paying the interest, which you are calling the coupon rates up to the time the bond matures. Alright? And in most cases, bonds involve huge sums of money. Good. Let's look at an example and try to understand these things. Alright? Maybe before we go, the star I can erase this part, which I'm going to use. So this topic is very interesting because it's real, which is about things that we know. Alright? Good. Now, let's look at an example. On January 1st, 2020, which is last year, Kam's bond, alright, purchased 1,000 from government. Alright? This, it is a name of a company which is called Kam's bond. Alright? Purchased 1,000 kwacha from government. Now, what do you mean by purchasing? In this case, it's not that this person is the one that bought, but the government issued the bond. Now, the money was given to government. Alright? So, on January 1st, when Kam's bond purchased 1,000 kwacha from government. Now, according to the terms of the bond, which matures in 7 years, government will pay Kam's, alright? 5% interest, alright? 5% interest on December 31st. So, according to the conditions or terms of the bond, is that this bond will mature in 7 years, and the government will pay or be paid Kam's bond 5% interest on December 31st. So every 31st of December, the government pays the coupon rate. Alright? Now, A. So we have our answers here. I hope the question is very clear. A. What is the face value of the bond? Alright? We are saying Kam's bond purchased 1,000 kwacha from government. So the face value here is the 1,000 kwacha. That is the money that government has issued in terms of bond. Alright? B. Good. What is the bond's coupon rate? By bond's coupon rate, we are saying at what interest will the bond be paid? And the interest here is 5%. So the coupon rate is 5%. Alright? Calculate the amount of interest that Kam's will receive each year. Now, we are saying remember this is a fixed interest rate. Alright? So the interest payable per year is equal to 5% of the face value. 5% of the face value. And what is our face value? 1,000. What? Alright? So we are going to say, of course, these zeros will come from the two zeros we have put in. 50 by 10, we have got 50 by 10. Alright? So, the interest that Kam's will be receiving every year is 50 kwacha. So 50 kwacha, 50 kwacha, 50 kwacha for 7 years. Alright? D. Find the amount of interest that Kam's will receive over the life of the bond. Life of the bond simply means the period in which the bond shall be serviced. Alright? In this case, we are talking about 7 years. Alright? So we are saying, find the amount of interest that Kam's will receive over the life of the bond. How much will this person receive over that period of 7 years? So we are saying the amount here will be equal to how many years will this bond be serviced? It is in 7 years, alright? So 7 times. What is the coupon rate? Coupon rate is 5%. 5% gives us 50 quarts per year. So times 50 quarts. So this will give us what? 350 quarts. Alright? So in 7 years, this person will have received an interest of 350 quarts. Good. Very interesting. E. State and maturity dates of the bond. Look, this bond was purchased on the 1st of January 2020, and that it will mature in 7 years. Meaning that you start counting from 2020 itself. So, meaning that from 2020, when you add 7, it will take you to 2026. So, it will mature on 31st December 2026. 31st December 2026. That is when the bond will mature. Alright? Or what we are calling the maturity date of the bond. Good. Then we go to what? F. F. Alright, keep my pieces here. F. F. What is F saying? Calculate the amount that comes will receive when the bond matures. Very interesting. So what they're saying is, this person will be receiving 50 kwacha every year for 7 years. So in total, the interest will be 50. Now the question is, calculate the amount that funds will receive when the bond matures. Look, when the bond matures, this person is going to receive, all right, amount. Is going to receive two things when the bond matures. The year that the bond will mature, this person will receive two things. What are these? One, the face value. Alright? So the face value will pay, which is 1,000, because it has matured. Two, the interest, because that year, the last year, that is 2026. There will also be an interest of 50 kwacha. 50 kwacha will have accrued as interest. So you say plus 50 kwacha. Alright? So what is this amount? So 1050 kwacha. This is how much this person will have received when the bond matures. Alright? Good. Then we go to G. We go to G. By buying 1,000 gold from the government. In other words, what is he going to get in total as a result of him buying the bond from government? So what he's going to get is the face value as well as the interest. So the face value is 1,000 plus the interest, which is 350. So for the next 7 year period, this person will have accumulated an interest of 350 kwacha plus the interest plus the face value that was in that was purchased. So all together, this will give us what? Will give us 1,350 kwacha. All right. This is how much this person will have
received as a result of the investment or the purchasing of the bond. So remember, when you say whatever about the bond, you are simply talking about the loan. Alright? And the interest that you pay as you try to service the bond is what we are calling the coupon rate. And the amount that is purchased is referred to as the face value. So you pay the face value at the end or when the bond matures. But in the process of servicing the bond, you pay what we call coupon rates. And the people that issue or that purchase bonds are referred to as what? Bond holders. Don't make a mistake, there's no need to default on the coupon rates, otherwise it can be its own consequences. I think that's why we aim for this presentation. Thanks so much.